Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how to get rid of those trailing spaces in Microsoft Excel. So today we are going to show you how to clean up your data using the trim function, the trim and clean function, find and replace, and the substitute function. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So here's my data set. And while it looks like the data here and here are the same, if I go over here and I type equals, and I click on A2 equals B2 and hit enter, I'm going to get a false. And if I look a little more closely at my data, say I double click in A2, I can see that there's a space right here at the end. And in B2, that space is not there. So how do I go about cleaning up A2? So let me show you how you can clean column A to not have those spaces. If I click in B2 and I type equals and I type the word trim with a left parenthesis and I click in A2 and hit enter, I have essentially cleaned up what is in A2 in B2. And I can prove this over here in column C. So I'm going to right click and go to copy, and then I'm going to click on C2, and over here I'm going to go to paste, and I'm going to select this option right here when I hover over it that says values. So now I have just a name in here. So if I double click in here, there is no space at the end. But if I double click at the end here, there is a space. So this is the cleaned up version of what I have over here. So now that I have put the formula in for the trim, I'm going to go to the bottom right-hand corner of B2, and you see this square here? If I hover my mouse over where it turns into a very thin cross, I can click with my left mouse button and just drag down to the end of my data set. And I can see that using the trim function cleans up what I have in column A, and the cleaned up version is in column B.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
If the trim function alone isn't working for you because sometimes there are some non-printable characters, let's try using the trim and clean. So I'm going to type in B2 and I'm going to type equals clean with the left parenthesis and I'm going to click on A2 and hit enter. But if I click on B2 and I copy this formula down one cell, you can see that I'm still getting this first space here. So I'm going to go back to A2, and in between the equal sign and the clean, I'm going to put the word trim with a left parenthesis and then a right parenthesis at the end and hit enter. And now when I click on B2 and I drag that formula all the way to the bottom of my data set, I can now see that that has been cleaned up using the trim and the clean function. So sometimes you may need to use the clean function and sometimes you may not. Our next option is find and replace. So if I highlight my data set and hit Control F on the keyboard, I will get the find and the replace dialog box. So I'm going to click on the replace tab and I'm asked, what do I want to find? And I'm just going to type in a space. And what do I want to replace it with? In this cell, I am going to type nothing at all. And then I'm just going to click replace all. And then I can see that 16 replacements were made. And I'm going to say okay, and then close. But as you can see, using the find and replace is a little more tricky than using the trim function because it gets rid of every space, no matter where it is. So not only did it get rid of the trailing spaces or the beginning spaces, but you can see it also got rid of the spaces in between the first name and the last name. So in some cases you may want that, in some cases you may not. And my final option is the substitute function. So if I go here and click in B2, I'm going to type equals substitute with a left parenthesis. And the first argument I'm being prompted for is what text am I looking in to do a substitution? So I'm going to click in A2. And then I'm going to type a comma. And the old text, it's kind of like the find and replace that we just did. The old text is what text I want to get rid of. So I'm going to use a double quote, a space, and a double quote, because the space is what I want to get rid of. And then I'm going to type a comma. And now I'm going to be prompted for new text. So what do I want to replace the space with? Well, I want to replace the space with nothing. So I'm just going to put two double quotes next to each other, end my parentheses, and hit enter. And then I can click in B2 and hover my mouse over the bottom right-hand corner until I get this thin cross and just drag all the way down to the end of my data set. But please note that the substitute function has the same issue as find and replace. It will replace all spaces with the nothing that we put in there. So just keep that in mind in case you want to keep some of your spaces. Because if you want to get rid of trailing spaces, either at the beginning or the end, you may want to use trim or trim with the clean function. If you don't care and you just want to get rid of all spaces that are in there, you can use find and replace, or you can use the substitute function. Just keep in mind, if you use find and replace, that's a one-time change. And if you get new data, you'll have to do find and replace again. Whereas if you use the substitute function, it's built into the cell that's before it. So if you change the cell before it, the column with the substitute function will change as well. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction for some ways to get rid of spaces, line breaks, and other non-printable characters in Microsoft Excel. I'm going to include a link to our blog on this topic in the description below on YouTube. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.